Welcome to Understand the Math. Today I'm going to give you a quick review of exponential functions. I'll explain everything you need to know about them so you'll be ready to use them in calculus or apply them in other disciplines. Be sure to check out the link below for free guided notes that you can use as you watch this video. This is really important because we're going to go over a lot of concepts, and if you have the notes, you can highlight important points and then keep the notes for future reference. I've organized this review into the four different topics that I've listed here. Let's begin with an overview of the exponential function. There are two main types of exponential functions. The first is y is equal to a times b raised to the x power, where b is greater than 1. This function grows exponentially. The second is also y is equal to a times b raised to the x. However, for this one, our b is between 0 and 1. This function decays exponentially. Let's look at our function in a little bit more detail. An exponential function is written as f of x is equal to a times b raised to the x. A is our initial value, and it can be found by letting x be equal to 0. B is our base, and it's greater than 0, and it's not equal to 1. X is called the exponent. One thing that's really important when studying exponential functions, or all functions really, is to understand what type of problems can be modeled by this type of function. Exponential functions can be used to model problems that change by a constant percentage over time. We call this a proportional rate of change. I'll show you two examples of this. The first is when you have cells in a petri dish that divide and double each hour. This can be modeled by an equation y is equal to 100 times 2 raised to the t. Let's see how this represents what we call a proportional rate of change. When t is 0, y is going to be equal to 100. When t is 1, we can see that y is equal to 100 times 2 raised to the first power, which is equal to 200. And then when t is 2, we end up with y is equal to 400. The function is changing at a rate proportional to its current value. Each year, the amount is multiplied by 2 or doubles. Another common example of using an exponential model is money that is invested and increases by a certain percentage each year. One way to recognize if a problem can be modeled by an exponential function is to look to see if the new amount is equal to a number or base b times the old amount. Just like with our cells in a petri dish, the new amount was 2 times the old amount. We write this mathematically as f of t plus 1 is equal to b times f of t, or depending on which variable you're using, this could be written as f of x plus 1 is equal to b times f of x. This is in contrast to a linear function where the new amount is equal to the old amount plus a number. That last part was pretty theoretical. Now we're going to look at something easier, which is basic rules for exponents. If you're following along with the guided notes, we're going to fill in this part because I found that students remember formulas better if you actually fill them in instead of just look at them. When you work with exponential functions, there's 5 rules that always come up that you need to make sure and know. The first one is b to the x times b to the y. This is going to be equal to b to the x plus y. You add the exponents. For the second one, when you have b to the x divided by b to the y, instead of adding the exponents, you're going to subtract them. Our third one is b to the x raised to the y, and in this case, you multiply the exponents. Our fourth one is b raised to the 0. So any number other than 0 raised to the 0 is going to equal 1. Our last one is b to the minus x, and this is equal to 1 over b raised to the x. You can think of b to the minus x as b to the minus 1 raised to the x. So this is 1 over b raised to the x, which is 1 over b to the x. if we have 1/2 raised to the x, this is just the same as 2 to the minus x. Let's now look at some more graphs and talk about some of the basic properties of exponential functions. These are the same two graphs that we had on the previous page. The one on the left exhibits exponential growth, and our base b is greater than 1, and the one on the right exhibits exponential decay, and our base is between 0 and 1. Let's notice that in both graphs, x can be any value between minus infinity and infinity, so the domain for both of these functions is minus infinity to infinity. Let's also notice that y can only go from 0 to infinity, so the range is from 0 to infinity. Notice that 0 is not included because the x-axis is an asymptote and the function never equals 0. If you add a constant to these two functions, the graph will shift vertically up or down and this range will change. Let's now just focus on the graph on the left. The graph is always increasing because it always goes from a smaller value to a larger value. It's concave up. If this function were equal to 2 to the x, it would go to infinity as x goes to infinity, and it would go to 0 as x goes to minus infinity. Let's now turn our attention to the function on the right. This function is decreasing because it always goes from a larger value to a smaller value. It's concave up, just like the one on the left. And then if this graph was equal to 1/2 to the x, it goes to 0 as x goes to infinity, and it goes to infinity as x goes to minus infinity. Let's now look at the graphs at the bottom of the page. If you have a function that's increasing exponentially, a larger base produces a steeper curve. So 4 to the x is going to be steeper than 2 to the x. If you have a function that decays exponentially, a smaller base is going to produce a steeper curve. The function 1/4 to the x has the smaller base and it's steeper than the function 1/2 raised to the x. The last topic that we're going to go over is the natural exponential function. This function is used widely in mathematics and in science, engineering, and business. It's written as f of x is equal to e raised to the x. It's just a special case of the exponential function a times b to the x, where a is equal to 1 and our base b is equal to e. E is called Euler's number, and it's an irrational number equal to 2.71828, and then it just goes on with more numbers. If you go on to study calculus, you'll see e defined as the limit as n goes to infinity of 1 plus 1 over n raised to the n. Let's now take a look at the graphs of the functions e to the x and e to the minus x. The function e to the x grows exponentially, and the function e to the minus x decays exponentially. When you study calculus, you're often looking at the end behavior of both of these functions. One easy way to remember the end behavior is to actually graph the functions. E to the x goes to infinity as x goes to infinity, and e to the x goes to 0 as x goes to minus infinity. Let's now look at e to the minus x. It's going to be just the opposite. E to the minus x is going to go to 0 as x goes to infinity, and e to the minus x is going to go to infinity as x goes to minus infinity. I hope this video has helped you review exponential functions and that you're now better prepared to use these functions in future courses or calculations. If this video has been helpful to you, please consider subscribing to my channel. Keep believing in yourself and have a great rest of your day.